What's up, my dudes? My name is Sister Turley, and this is the track review of the JGMX Grief Compound. And these JGMX dudes have been spitting them out here lately. Jeez, they've been making a ton of tracks out there, man. So these JGMX guys, they make a track about every couple of weeks, and they're pretty solid. I mean, some of them are a little basic as far as the off-track stuff, but I mean, you can always guarantee their on-track jumps and roughness and stuff like that is going to be pretty on point. They pretty much established that by now. So I just looked at this track and thought, all right, I can feel that vibe, because a lot of the off-track looked pretty cool and somewhat unique. It had kind of a, you can see how it's almost got a desert type feeling, but it's not at the same time. That's kind of weird to say that, but like some of the off track is just has more of a, it's not like super lush green trees everywhere, so it's kind of a interesting mix between like a desert and sort of a woodland type biome going on here. And it's got a lot of really fun unique off camber jump sections. Got a little water section right there, and you can pop over that and do a little triple, and then you can hook the crap out of this right here and jump it all the way. Oh my gosh, man, that is a gnarly jump. Just be careful and just make sure you hit it hard enough to get over to the part where you're actually landing on a little bit of a downhill slope. You don't want to land right on the right where that landing actually goes upward, or you're just gonna pop right off the bike. Gotta be super careful right there, but everywhere else is really not super difficult on this track. It's got some fun pretty bigger style jumps on it, but it's not a super simple track either. I mean, you have ruts in the corners, you got some corners that where you can really pick the inside or the outside, and it's gonna really change how you hit that next rhythm section, whether it's like rollers or there's a section where you can actually do a triple, or you could just do a double if you hit the inside. So you have a lot of different types of rhythms you can hit, whether you take the inside or the outside, which is really cool. And I feel like that's how a lot of motocross tracks should be, because that's why you would get a benefit or a negative effect from taking the inside or the outside. If you just have some jump where you can still hit it from the inside, then why would you ever go on the outside? You know what I'm saying? Unless you have something like roughness on the inside to be more of a balancer to it. And this is that crazy big jump right there. And I am not used to whipping it that way. Is it just me, or do some of you other guys out there get to almost sort of a habit where you always want to whip it one direction, and then you wake up one day and it's like, oh my gosh, I don't even know how to whip the other way whatsoever. Is that just me, or does everybody do that? I don't know. I get in such a habit of wanting to whip the back end out. I guess I would whip the front end over to the left. That's kind of more of my habit. I know some people probably have the habit of whipping it the other way, but I think you always get more of a natural want to whip it one side to the or the other, and you're always better at whipping it on that one side. You know what I'm saying? It always just feels more natural to you. And I've always had that feeling in real life riding as well. I always wanted to whip it that same way as I do in MX Simulator. That's kind of a weird thing. I never really thought about that before, but the way I whip in real life is the natural way that I want to whip in MX Simulator as well. So I don't know if that's just something how your brain works, you want to whip it that certain way or whatever. I mean, I can whip it the other way, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying I can't. It's just that one way feels a lot more natural to me, and same way in real life. So it's kind of weird like that, but pretty cool. I don't know, definitely let me know in the comments what you guys think about if you have a natural way you whip it, and if it's feels kind of weird whipping it the other way. I guess if I really focused on whipping it that other way, then I would get a lot better at it and it would start to feel way more natural to me. But as of right now, it just, anytime I come up to a big jump and I want to whip it out there real far, it's like I always just have the tendency to want to whip the front end over to the left and the back end's coming out on the right side. So that's kind of, I guess, my little bit of a habit I have, but I don't really know if that's the way it is for everybody. Like I'm saying, I don't know, it could just be me being all crazy and how I usually am. A lot of things for me is not the same for everybody else, but, and I do things in a very simple way a lot of the times too, so a lot of people don't do it like I do it, but that's kind of the way it is, man. But yeah, this track definitely solid as far as all your off-track mountains in the background and stuff. Definitely looks pretty realistic. It's not just a skybox, that's all actually built up area over there, so it definitely gives it more of a realistic feel. And it's got some different grass billboards here and there, which is cool. That's always a definitely a plus. You never want to get too repetitive on the kind of trees you use off the track, or the kind of billboard, grass billboards and stuff like that. That will make a track look so bland and basic whenever you get too repetitive with one with one type of thing. And same way with a decal or whatever, you know, if you just use one kind of decal off the track, it's going to look super repetitive. So that's a really big tip. Like, at least throw two or three different variations of something as far as your billboards and decals and statues and stuff like that. But the little water statues he's got over there and stuff, they look pretty good. They definitely match this track. It's kind of a just an interesting, it's not like super blue, but it's a just kind of, man, it just really matches the environment. I don't know, it just almost has that like orange sunset haze over the water, so it looks really like it fits in this track. So what's cool about a lot of these sections where you get the long roller sections, I think there's two or three on this track, and the cool thing is like you can run it up the inside, and it's pretty cool because you can kind of get in a doubling rhythm, or you can rail it around the outside and try to, you know, it takes a longer distance to go around the outside, but once you get on the roller section, you can hit them a lot faster and just roll over them. So you have a lot of different line options on this track, and it allows you to really try different things, and you don't just get bored instantly on the track. So that's kind of one thing I noticed about it as well. But as far as your roughness and everything, I would say it's probably somewhere in that medium roughness, definitely not AMA style. I mean, you have a couple little sections where it gets a little more bumpy, but the way this roughness is built on this track is really well. This is how I like roughness to be built. I'm not necessarily saying how much or how less it is, I'm just saying how the bumps are actually built. I feel like this is how they should be built on every motocross track out there, just as far as how the, I don't know how to explain that, but a lot of these newer AMA 2016 roughness, it's just so bizarre the way they build it, and it just, there's no other explanation for it. I mean, it's not even necessarily how big it is or how small it is, but it's just the way they build it. But like this right here, it's actually somewhat predictable. The roughness, you can kind of tell what the bike's going to do over it. It doesn't just randomly pop you over in some weird direction and you don't even know what the heck was going on. Like, it's somewhat predictable because the roughness actually feels like it would be in real life. So that's kind of a cool thing about this track that you'll notice. But that's definitely a hook right there, man. A lot of fun. Love when people throw in fun, bigger jumps like that, that you don't necessarily have to hit it if you're not that fast, but you still have that option. There's nothing more fun to me than having big jump sections and stuff like that, that you really got to think outside of the box to even realize that you could hit it. But it's cool because even if you are hitting it, it's hard enough to where it's not super easy to hit every lap, even if you are a pro. So it's got like everything from, you know, a beginner could ride on this track pretty well, but it also has those really big jumps for, if a pro wants to get pretty competitive on this track, there's also that option. So I love when tracks are able to bring it all together like that. That's a really hard thing to do if you've ever made a track on this game. That's a pretty difficult, challenging thing to make a track easy but challenging and able to be fun for all skill level of riders. That's one of the hardest things to do, but definitely pretty cool, well-built track. So I'm going to give this track a 9 overall, and I'm going to say the difficulty is, it's probably right about that medium range. I mean, you got some bigger jumps here and there, but they're not super difficult. I mean, they're just fun. They look really big, and you can whip it all the way backwards, but they're not where you got to be crazy, full blast, 7th gear on a 450 or anything like that. So, anyways, thanks for watching the video. Later, dudes.